This morning, my topic as led by the Lord is the real you. Okay. Sino ka? Ano ba yung definition ng real? Not artificial. You're not fraudulent. You are not illusory. You are genuine. The genuine article. Bumili ka ng Levi's sa totoo, bumili ka ng Levi's sa Divisoria, iba ang pakiramdam pag ginamit mo. Kaya nga mas mahal ang totoo na Levi's kasera sa fake. Kaya nga mas mahal magpakatotoo kasera sa magsinungaling. Ang daling magpanggap, pero ang hirap magpakatotoo. Pag tinanong ka, kamusta ka na? Ang sabi mo, I'm fine. Pero hindi, I'm depressed pala, I am lost, di ba? I am suffering, I am in a difficult situation, I am confused. Yung ka na eh. Eh, ang daling sabihin, okay lang. And who says that you are okay when you are not? It's the lie inside of us. Kasi paniniwalaan ng mundo dahil kay Satan, okay lang magsinungaling. Hindi. Kahit kailan, hindi okay magsinungaling. You have to be real as you can be. Kasi how can you be real to yourself if you are a liar? If you will continuously lie. So if you lie, then your life is a lie. Ayan. Ano pa raw ang definition ng real? Having objective, independent existence. I love this definition. Ibig sabihin, you can live, quote and unquote, alone. You can stand alone. You don't need friends. All you need is your family and your church. Objective. Remember objective, yung you make decisions rationally, not emotionally. You make decisions logically. Okay? And you make decisions that is based on the truth. Katotohanan. Hindi kasinungalingan. Try natin. So, pakibasa please. 1, 2, 3, go. Exactly. Hindi mo alam yung gusto mong gawin sa buhay. That's why you're confused because you don't know who you are. Again, it's only God who can reveal to you who you are because God is our creator. We try and find the definition of our lives, our value system, our culture on the basis of the world. Kaya nga sabi ng Panginoon, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Nasa utak kasi ang laban eh. Nasa utak naniniwala ang isang individual kung sino siya and how he or she is supposed to live. Kaya nga, to know the real you means to do what is going to give you the most satisfying lifestyle. And this is our carrier verse, 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 10. Once you had no identity, hindi mo kilala kung sino ka, as a people, it was collective for the whole nation of Israel, now you are God's people. Once you receive no mercy, now you have received God's mercy. Without the element of God in our lives, we will never know our identity. That is why you will die not knowing the real you. I love the Message version. Sabi dyan, from nothing to something, from rejected to accepted. Tuloy natin. One of the deepest mysteries is finding who is the real me. So when you find the real you, when you have a relationship with God, that's the most beautiful thing that can happen. Pag nakilala mo talaga kung sino ka, according to God's will. Paibasa please. 1, 2, 3, go. So, yung mga bata sa Mercedes, I talk to them about loving yourself. Kasi when you say loving yourself, parang it sounds so selfish, but it's not. Because God commanded you to love yourself. Second commandment, sabi, love your neighbors as you love yourself. When you love yourself, you protect yourself. You protect yourself. Ulitin ko, you protect yourself. So, ang ginagawa mo ngayon, you are creating the foundation sa pag-ibig mo sa sarili mo, which is not wrong because that's the only capacity we can love others the way we love ourselves. Kaya nga, a person who hates himself will hate eventually the person he or she has a relationship with. Kaya ang daming jealousy, ang daming suspicion, ang daming malice dun sa relationship, ang daming distrust issues. But if you love yourself, you are easily true to yourself and true to your partners, true to your wives, true to your children, true to your neighbors, true to everyone. Kaya importante, you know how to love yourself so that you will value who you are and protect your heritage. Because if you love yourself, naturally, your love will be emitting to others. And a lot of people, they don't accept that I hate myself. Tanungin mo na lang, anong klaseng kaibigan meron ka? Are these friends nagsasabi ng totoo? Kung ang mga kaibigan mo mga sinungaling, you hate yourself. Kung mga kaibigan mo mga totoo, ready to hurt you at any given moment because they love you, then you love yourself because you surround yourself with honest people. You surround yourself with people who will encourage you to become the best version of who you are. So, let's break it down. I'm just going to read this to you again, tapos isa-isahin natin. So, 1 Peter chapter 2, 9 to 12, NLT version, but you are not like that. Sinasabi ni Peter sa mga Jewish Christians, oy, tapos na yan, nakaraan na yan, hindi na kayo ganyan. Huwag niyong sabihin kasi ganito ako. Huwag niyong sabihin kasi ito yung naman akong ugali. Hindi, tapos na yon. Tapos na yon, sabi niya. Ano raw, sabi niya, for you are a chosen people, you are a royal priest, a holy nation, God's very own possession. As a result, you can show others the goodness of God, for He called you out of the darkness into His wonderful light. Once you had no identity as a people, now you are God's people. Once you received no mercy, now you have received God's mercy. Kaya, ang lupit nung word na yon sa mga Israelites, because they were ruled by the Babylonians after the time ng mga kings. And they received no mercy. Alam nyo yung tax nung araw sa mga Israelites? It's 40%. Nagre-reklamo ka, 32-30 ang tax mo. During that time, it was 40%. Kaya nga nun, sinabi yan ni Peter dun sa Jewish Christians, they can relate, yes, now we receive compassion. Because before, our rulers, Roman Empire, during this time, you know, they just treated us like trash. Next. Dear friends, I warn you as temporary residents and foreigners to keep away from worldly desires that wage war against your very souls. Be careful to live properly among your unbelieving neighbors. Then, even if they accuse you of doing wrong, they will see your honorable behavior and they will give honor to God when He judges the world. Nasa pamumuhay kasi natin, maniniwala ang mga tao sa kapaligiran natin about God. Now, let's break it down. Number one, this is the real you. You are God's possession and you are a chosen people. So, hindi sinabing you are chosen as individuals lang. You are a chosen people. That's why God instituted the church. The church is supposed to help everyone who comes to church. Balikan mo yung nakaraan mo. Ano mas masaya? Nasa mundo ka o nasa loob ka ng simbahan? You are chosen by God. Number two, you are royal priests. Ano ibig sabihin nito? You are already pastors because you are going to inspire others. That is why Peter said, generically, kasi remember, during that time, isang tribu lang ng Israel ang mga pare. This is the tribe of Levi. And then, Peter comes, no, it's not only the tribe of Levi anymore who is going to pastor, it's going to be everyone. And sabi niya, holy nation. When you are with holy people, you become holy. When you are with evil people, you become evil. It's going to be as simple as that. Kaya sabi mo sa sarili mo right now, if you are born again believer, I am holy. One more, I am holy. One more, I am holy. When you say those things and believe in it, you will live a holy life. If you say that I am a sinner, then you will become a sinner. Kasi sineset mo yung mind mo to sin. Next, the real you. You are called out of darkness into His wonderful light. Nasa dilim ka, dinala ka sa liwanag so that you can see clearly. Hindi ka makakita ng maayos sa dilim. Sabi nga ng mga iba, when it's pitch dark, you only have a meter's length of vision. So hanggang dyan lang makikita mo. Ganun yung buhay na wala sa Panginoon. Kaya tuloy namumuhay ka destructively because you don't have that type of perspective. Sabi dyan, I love this, you had no identity as a people, now you are God's people. Alam nyo ba, Filipinos are tribal in nature. Nung araw, before the Spanish came, walang muhon ang mga properties. Everybody had everything in common. So pag part ka ng tribo, whatever the chief has, whatever the elders have, whatever the young ones have, you had everything. Then came the Spaniards, started to divide the land, and started to divide our nation, our people. So sinira nila identity natin. You have your identity. And kung yung ilong mo ganyan, mahalin mo yung ilong mo. Okay, kung height mo ganyan, mahalin mo yung height mo. Ayan, na-explain ko na kanina, now you have received mercy. Ano ang ibig sabihin ng mercy? It comes from the Greek word eleo. Compassionate by word or deed, especially by divine grace. That is our reward. From darkness to light, able to identify who you are and the reception of God's mercy. And the last is this. Naaliwa ko sa mga tao because this is what the world trained us to be. Ang daming mga taong hoarders. Pansin nyo? Ang daming gamit sa bahay na hindi kailangan. Pwedeng itapon kasi hindi kailangan. Okay? Kasi dadagain lang yan, magiging bahay ng ipis. Tapon nyo na o pamigay nyo para may makinabang na iba. Kung yung damit nyo, hindi mo nagamit ng 8 buwan, ibig sabihin, panahon na para ipamigay yun. Okay? Hindi yung pag hinugot mong ganun, ay. Babalik mo. Hindi mo naman ginagamit. Diba? Ang daming bahay, too much clutter. Ano sabi ng Panginoon? You are temporary residents, foreigners in this land because your destination is heaven. Ano pa raw? Keep away from worldly desires that wage war against your very souls. Souls, for this discussion, is your emotions and your belief system and intellect. So, ibig sabihin, you've got to keep away from, you know, what the world dictates you to do. And ako, I encourage you to become minimalist. I encourage you. Kasi, ang daming clutter eh. Naniniwala ako, pag ang isang tao maraming clutter, confused yung taong yun. You have to declutter your mind because it makes you confused. Sabi ng iba, detoxify. Okay? It's the same thing. And of course, ang huli dyan, the lifestyle of the real you is careful to live properly among your unbelieving neighbors, for the non-Christians. Then even if they accuse you of doing wrong, they will see your honorable behavior and they will give honor to God when He judges the world. So ang ganda ng exchange. Knowing the real you from the perspective of God will make you better people. Let's bow down our heads and close our eyes.